Emotional reunions after months of separation. 43,000 visitors have applied to enter South Australia, hundreds crossing the Victorian border at midnight.
Very, very excited to be back. I think I'm going to cry.
It's almost like a scene from Love Actually, as friends and families are reunited.
So with the start of flying, we're going to start with close to 100 flights this week between Qantas and Jetstar. And we're going to work our way through to close to 650 flights by the time we get to January.
Those entering with children aged under 12 or coming from LGAs where vaccinations are between 80 and 90% will still need a COVID-19 test, but are not required to quarantine. Meanwhile, the state's own vaccination rate is just 78%, with some LGAs still lagging below 70.
At the moment, we're looking at well over 20% chance of a major outbreak at the current vaccination rate. So if we waited another couple of weeks, that would be much greatly reduced.
It's an exciting time for many families for the connection with their loved ones interstate. But there's also a little bit of apprehension about what's in store for us. Are there more lockdowns, particularly during the festive season?
Despite a concerted effort in recent weeks, here in Playford in Adelaide's north, just 65% of the population have received two doses. Multicultural leaders are calling for bilingual health professionals to support their messaging.
We know that some of the communities are a little bit hesitant. I don't know why they're hesitant, but there's obviously some issues that need to be addressed.
And just 40% of Indigenous South Australians have been double jabbed.
The fear of the vaccine has become less than the fear of the virus.
Premier Marshall remaining optimistic.
I think we'll get to 79% vaccination for those people 16 and over today.
He says restrictions will be further relaxed when the state reaches 90%. But with an 18% vaccine hesitancy rate in South Australia, the next steps remain a challenge. Peter Doherty, SBS World News.